peace depends on justice, and economic progress depends on peace. This will only happen when man recognizes his creator, and only then will the rights of God's creation be discharged. We hold a passionate desire to establish peace and to end cruelty in light of the true Islamic teachings. The Ahmadiyya community claims, and indeed those who are closely associated with us are witness to this, that not only do we raise a slogan for peace, but in fact we make practical efforts to establish tolerance, peace, and patience. In short, the disorder taking place these days in the world, whether on a national or international scale, is based upon just one factor, and that is a complete lack of justice, which is causing anxiety and restlessness to develop. The question arises that how can the present situation in the world be resolved? I have given the answer to this earlier when quoting the writing of the founder of the Ahmadiyya community, in which he advised us to establish a relationship with God and exhibit the truth. The purpose of every religion has been to bring man closer to God and to establish human values. Let us look at what Islam really represents. The meaning of the word Islam itself means peace, love, and security. Thus, if anybody portrays Islam as an extreme and violent religion filled with teachings of bloodshed, then such a portrayal has no link with the real Islam. From cover to cover, the Holy Quran teaches love, affection, peace, reconciliation, and the spirit of sacrifice. And the Ahmadiyya Muslim community propagates this very message. The Ahmadiyya Muslim community is marching forward with this mission so as to cause people to recognize God, their creator. We can recognize God through our loyalty and sincerity towards Him. It is in this way that the beautiful teaching of Islam, of peace, harmony, and reconciliation can be displayed. A mosque is a place of worship for Muslims, and it is built for worshiping God five times daily. And this is and should be its true purpose.
Allahu Akbar.
Masjid jo hai ye peace aur aman ka nishan hai. Aur Quran Kareem mein jo Baitullah hai uske mutalliq ye kaha gaya hai ki jo koi isme dakhil hoga wo aman mein hoga. مساجد تو امن کا گہوارہ ہے اور مساجد سے محبت اور پیار کا سبق دیا جاتا ہے دہشت گردی کا سبق ہرگز نہیں دیا جاتا حضور نے فرمایا کہ جہاں جماعت کی بنیاد رکھتی ہو حضرت مسیح نے فرمایا جہاں جماعت کی بنیاد رکھتی ہو وہاں ایک مسجد بنا دیں تو پھر جماعت کی بنیاد پڑ جائے گی تو اللہ تعالیٰ کا فضل ہے کہ حضرت مسیح علیہ السلام کے ان الفاظ کو ہم اپنی آنکھوں سے پورا ہوتے ہوئے دنیا بھر کے ملکوں میں دیکھ رہے ہیں جہاں مسجد بن جاتی ہے وہاں جماعت پھیل جاتی ہے اس کی دو وجوہات ہوتی ہیں ایک تو جماعت کے جو ممبران ہیں وہ اپنے بچوں کی تربیت کی غرض سے مساجد کے قریب آ جاتے ہیں کہ بچے مسجد میں جائیں گے کلاسز اٹینڈ کریں گے درس سنیں گے دوسرا یہ کہ جو ارد گرد کے لوگ غیر مسلم ہیں ان کو توجہ پیدا ہوتی ہے کہ یہ کیا کرتے ہیں چنانچہ جو نور مسجد ہے جو ہماری پرانی بلڈنگ تھی और चूँकि बिल्डिंग की बाहर ज़ाहिर बाहर की जो शेप है वो एक पुरानी बिल्डिंग की तरह है, उसको देख के लोग आ जाते हैं कि बिल्डिंग किस किस्म की है, और जब फिर आते हैं तो फिर वो उनको पता लगता है कि मस्जिद है, तो उसकी वजह से भी बहुत इंटरेस्ट लेते हैं, फिर लिटरेचर लेके जाते हैं।
Because I became an Ahmadiyya Muslim in 1957 and was then given the name Nur Ahmad. We were three young boys at that time who became Ahmadiyya Muslims. There were no other Muslims in Norway at that time. From the beginning of the 1970s, we got a lot of immigrants here from Pakistan. And we slowly got a Jamaat, and it was a problem for us that we didn't have a place which was our own. We had to hire some hall now and then for prayers and for meetings. Then we were searching again and again and again, tried to find a place, and then we got the place, the possibility to buy the place which we which was given the name after later, Noor Mosque. When we invite people, sometimes we had some kind of invitation pamphlet, and we said it was an ordinary house for families. It looks like a Greek temple. You can see that from the front. It is just like a Greek temple, but it is a mosque. So and of course, it was a great thing for us when we bought this, because suddenly we had a place of our own, and we could invite people who were interested to hear something about Islam. One thing is to hear about Islam when you sit in a hall in some other places, in a hotel or whatsoever. Another thing is when you come to a place which is a mosque, as this is.
My earliest memories from the childhood are related to the mosque. We lived not far from the mosque, only 15 minutes drive, and every weekend was spent in the mosque. It was a good environment. It was a decent environment, so we could play there after meetings or after athfal class. So I remember that well. And the years later also, there was always something happening in the weekends in the mosque. For a few years, I actually spent every single day in the mosque. And it was a good and very safe environment. And I always felt at home when I was at the mosque. It was the same feeling, the same calmness, the same, you know, feeling of safety. So it was good.
Now, and thinking about the large hall or halls in the new mosque, then it is almost impossible to imagine that this, once upon a time, this was too small. No, this was too large, much too large, I mean, much too large. But that is how our Jamaat has developed from the beginning. Of course, in 1957, that is one thing, but also from the beginning of the 1970s, when we slowly organized really as a Jamaat, and in the beginning we could have, well, one line had been not more than enough, the whole Jamaat, and then slowly more and more and more and now, and then too small. It is a blessing. It really is a blessing. And I was sitting there, and I'm looking to the right and looking to the left, and I was thinking, well, we are so few. And I thought, how would it be possible to fill this? And just when I was sitting there, then one of our members who came from Pakistan at the beginning of the 1970s, I mean, he was one of the first here. And then he came to me, and then he just, when I was sitting there wondering how could we ever be able to fill these holes, then he came to me and said, Noor Sahib, I mean, they are very polite, they say, Noor Sahib, he said, do you remember our mosque, our Noor Mosque? in the beginning, how large it was. We were so few, and the building was too large for us. And then, of course, I started to laugh, because yes, he was right. It was too big. It was. We were sitting very few in the hall, and it was quite ridiculous. I mean, our small Jamaat and this large building. But then, after a few years, we have trouble. On Friday prayer, it was not place enough inside. They had to pray here and also other special events. Oh, I start crying now. I mean, well, as you understand, this building means a lot to me. But it was too small. We had to pray inside, outside, here, everywhere. And so it was so nice that they came to me and mentioned this to me. Because, of course, and inshallah, probably not in my time because I'm old now, but in a few decades, at least, inshallah, our new large mosque will be too small, just like this one.
Lots of people.
And I mean, I've noticed in the Jamaat how much peace it has actually created amongst ourselves, amongst people that I haven't known. I've seen them in the mosque, or I've seen them somewhere else, but building the new mosque and being a part of it has brought us all together. But not only us, the people around here who were originally against the mosque because they're afraid of Muslims and for different reasons, most of them are actually quite happy. As far as I've read in the newspapers, they're surprised, positively surprised about how the shape is, but also how the community is. Because we're not bringing violence. We actually come to a place which is known for, well, was known for violence 20 years ago. And we're actually part of that peace-bringing process that both we as a community and the local government as a community are bringing into this place. We're part of that development process of this area.
Hazur ka aana hamare liye isliye be-intaha khushi ka baas hai ke Hazur 2005 mein tashreef laaye the. Uske baad jawad ke jo bhi ab aap Hazur se mulaqat ke liye jaate hain kehte hain Hazur darwaze tashreef laaye. ہاں لکھتے بھی خط بھی لکھتے حضور نے فرمایا کہ میں سے بناؤ گے تو تب آؤں گا تو اس وجہ سے ہمیں بڑی خواہش تھی کہ کاش مسجد بن جائے پھر حضور آئے اور جب مسجد بن گئی مسجد کا اجازت نامہ مل گیا پھر ہم نے حضور کی خدمت میں لکھا کہ حضور مسجد بن گئی ہے اجازت نامہ مل گیا ہے اب ہم استعمال کر رہے ہیں حضور تشریف لائے اور اس کے افتتاح کریں ہمیں اس بات کی خوشی ہے کہ ہم اپنے آقا کی خواہش پہ ہمیں خدا نے پورا اترنے کی توفیق عطا فرمائی اور اس بات کی خوشی ہے کہ ہمارے آقا یہاں تشریف لائے اور انشاءاللہ کل اس مسجد کا افتتاح فرمائیں گے اور پھر اس بات کی بھی خوشی ہے کہ اس مسجد کی برکت کے نتیجے میں ناروے میں انشاءاللہ اسلام کا نور پھیلے گا